United every time.
Agreed.
What? You're mad. It's Arsenal every single day of the week. Come on, you Gunners.
No way, Chris. Next thing you'll be telling me is that Stormzy's better than Drake.
I think you'll find he is.
I'm with Chris on that one. What? You two are off the block.
Okay. We'll have to agree to disagree on that and a whole host of other things for that matter.
Football and music are just two examples of how humans are different. Today, we are thinking about diversity and inclusion.
Here's what students from Archbishop Sancroft High School in Norfolk thought about what makes us different.
Diversity isn't just your ethnicity and the colour of your skin. It's your hair colour, your weight, your height, the way you think.
It could be how tall or short you are, sex, religion, beliefs, friends, family, or your likes and dislikes.
What makes us different is our backgrounds and our personalities. For example, I'm half Japanese.
We have different skills, we have different flaws, we have different views and opinions. We have different ideas.
There's obviously morals. What kind of things do you believe in? Do you have faith? Race, perspective, talents.
I have different ways of thinking and we have different ways of living. We have different ways of believing.
Truth is, the list goes on forever.
What you guys came up with, but I think it's pretty clear that we live in a wonderfully diverse world. We look different, we like different things, and we think differently.
And it's okay to not agree all the time. Difference isn't a bad thing.
Here's students again from the Archbishop Sancroft School giving us reason why we celebrate our differences.
I think we should celebrate our differences. You should never be ashamed of your like appearance or your backgrounds or anything. Also, use your differences to your advantage. For example, I can speak, write and read in different languages, which means I can communicate with more people.
By embracing our differences, it will help unite and educate us so we can view other people's perspectives and broaden our own.
Say you have a group of friends and they're really struggling to solve a problem. They're struggling because they have the same background, the same point of view, the same way of approaching the problem. So they decide to get someone else from a different background to come and help them solve the problem. Within minutes, that problem is solved. Not because that person is more intelligent than them, they were able to add their point of view and their approach to the conversation.
Nobody's ever influenced the world by trying to be like it, trying to be the same as kind of the stereotypical norms. You won't change anything by being the thing that needs to be changed.
I think being different should be celebrated because it makes us unique and it gives all of us a part to play in society and a part to play in our community.
It's easy to lose sight of the fact that we live in an incredibly diverse world.
It's estimated that 8 billion people will be living on this planet by the end of this decade.
To give you an impression of how diverse our world is, here is what our world would look like if we only had a population of 100 people. In a world of 100 people, 33 people would be Christian.
21 would be Muslim.
13 would be Hindu. There would be 6 Buddhists, 1 Sikh and 1 Jewish individual.
11 would practice other religions.
Whilst 3 would be atheists and 11 would call themselves non-religious. Similarly, in a world of 100 people, 12 would be European.
8 would come from North America.
There'd be 5 Latin Americans. Whilst 13 would come from Africa, 61 from Asia and 1 from Oceania.
Wow, what a world we live in.
For some reason though, instead of celebrating our differences and looking for what unites us, we focus on what divides us. Worryingly, we can separate humanity into groups and divide rather than include.
It's easy to place people in boxes, drawing lines, creating sides.
There's us, and there's them.
those we feel comfortable around.
And those we don't.
There are those with many chapters.
And those just starting their own stories.
There's the well-off.
And the not-so-well-off.
There are those that we share something with.
And those we don't seem to share anything with.
Welcome, and thank you for coming today, guys. Today I'm going to be conducting an experiment where I'll ask you a series of questions. Now, these questions will be very personal questions, and for us to get a true result, I need you to be completely honest with how you respond.
It's never nice being separated.
Being placed apart from others based on appearances or circumstances.
In the Bible, Jesus was radically inclusive.
He would welcome, help, and support everyone, no matter their age, race, circumstance, or social status.
I wonder what would happen if we focused more on what we have in common rather than what divides us.
Let's see what personal questions the man will ask.
And let's see how the picture can change and how it can change our world when we include rather than exclude.
The first question I have is, who in here was the class clown? Who is never on time?
There's more that unites us than divides us.
There's those of us who have tattoos.
Those who feel lonely.
Those who have been bullied.
Those who have bullied others.
Those who are madly in love.
Those who have overcome great challenges.
The lucky ones whose sports team won the championship this year.
There are people who have beaten cancer.
And then there's all of us, who the Bible says are created in the image of God.
Capable of great things when we come together.